Hello, my dear students. Welcome back in science classes. I am Jagpreet Kaur, your science teacher. Dear students, in this video, we will do the revision of first we will study the life cycle of the insects like cockroach and the butterfly. Then we will do the revision of chapter number 4. So let's start with the life cycle of an insect.
So this is an life cycle of a cockroach. Okay, as you can see, so there are the three steps. Okay, in life cycle of the cockroach there are the three steps. First is the egg. Okay, then means the adult female cockroach, they lay eggs. Then from the eggs, when the egg get hatched, then these small baby cockroach comes out, which is also known as the nymph. Okay, so at this stage, in the second stage, when the baby cockroach was there, in this state they molting takes place, means they shed off their skin many times, not only one time but the many times they do so. Okay, so at the stage of the nymph, means at the stage of the second, so this time the nymph or the baby cockroach, they do molting. Okay, they shed off their skin. So at this stage the nymph, it resembles with its parent. Okay, the nymph, it resembles with its parent. So and after that time, as it crosses this stage, then it goes to a third stage, that is an adult cockroach. Okay, that is an adult cockroach. So in the life cycle of the cockroach there are the three stages. First is in egg. Okay, the female cockroach, they lay egg. As the egg hatch, the nymphs come out. So the at this stage nymphs shed off their skin, that is known as the molting. Okay, after that it goes to the third stage, that is an adult cockroach. So now the life cycle of a butterfly. So in the life cycle of the butterfly there are the four stages. Okay, first stage, the egg is there. Okay, means the female, adult female butterfly, they lay eggs. After when the eggs get hatched, then the second stage comes, that is the larva. Larva stage, in this you can see the worm is there. Okay, and this worm is known as caterpillar, means the larva of a butterfly is known as the caterpillar, but of the housefly it is known as maggot, maggot, maggot. So the larva stage of the butterfly is known as a caterpillar. Worm is there, okay, that is known as a caterpillar. After when it goes to a third stage, then this larva, it covers itself in a cocoon. Okay, the when the third stage is there, then this larva or the caterpillar covers itself in a cocoon, and this stage is known as pupa. After this stage, when it is going to a next stage, in the fourth stage, then this pupa comes out from the cocoon, and as it comes out, it forms, it looks like an butterfly. Okay, it goes to an adult butterfly. So in the life cycle of the butterfly there are the four stages. First is the adult butterfly gives the or lays the eggs. So as the lay egg get hatched, then the worm like structure comes out, which is a larva stage of a butterfly. Okay, and it is known as a caterpillar. The larva of a butterfly is known as the caterpillar. Okay, so this worm eats the food. As it goes to the third stage, then this worm or the caterpillar cover itself in a cocoon. Okay, so after that, after some time, when the young butterfly comes out from the cocoon, then it goes to the another step, that is the adult butterfly. Okay,
So your chapter number 4 is animals living and surviving. Means how the animals live and how they survive. So they have adapted the things. Okay, whether it is here their eating habit or the living in the surrounding. Means the surrounding, the climatic conditions or the food availability, how they adjusted according to that. Okay, so first is adaptation according to the living habits. Okay, now what is adaptation? Adaptation means to adjust according to the surroundings. What is adaptation? Adaptation means to adjust according to the surroundings. Okay, so according to that, animals are divided into few groups. So the terrestrial animals. Now what are the terrestrial animals? Terrestrial animals are those animals which live on land. Okay, what are the terrestrial animals? Animals that live on land are known as the terrestrial animals. Okay, in the terrestrial animals, some arboreal are also come and the aerial also come. But as they spend more of the time on the trees or on in the sky, so according to that, again they are divided. First is the arboreal animal. What is the arboreal animal? Arboreal animal are those animals which spend most of the time on trees. Okay, the animals which spend more of the time on the trees are known as in arboreal animals. For example, like the lizard, the monkey, panda. Okay, so these are few examples of the arboreal animals which spend most of the time on trees. Now next is in aerial animals. Now what are the aerial animals? Aerial animals are those animals which spend most of the time in the sky. Okay, they are likely some of the insects, okay, and the birds, but all of the birds are not spend the time in sky only, because some of the birds are flightless birds. Okay, for example, like a penguin. Penguin is a flightless bird. So the same way, some other birds are also there which most of the time they spend on land. Okay, so the birds that spend most of the time in the sky are known as in aerial animals. Okay, the animals that spend most of the time in the sky are known as in aerial animals. For example, is the birds. Okay, the birds that be the sparrow, the parrot, the pigeon, okay, the eagle. So many of the birds are there which are aerial and they spend most of the time in the sky. Now the next is the aquatic animals. Now what are the aquatic animals? Aquatic animals are those animals which live in water. Okay, what are the aquatic animals? Aquatic animals are those animals which live in water, like the fish, the crabs. Okay, so these are an example of the animals that live in water. Okay. Now what are the amphibians? Amphibians are those animals which live in water as well as on land. What are the amphibians? The amphibians are those animals which live in water as well as on land. Okay, now terrestrial animals, they are having some features which they have adapted according to the land. Okay, as they are having the four legs, okay, so that they can walk, they can run. They are having a hairy body, so that according to the climatic condition, as the climatic change is there, the temperature changes, so the hairs that are present on their body, they can protect them. Okay. And the terrestrial animals are having the lungs, so that they can breathe. The terrestrial animals are having lungs, so that they can breathe. Okay. The same way the arboreal are also having the lungs, and the aerial animals are also having the lungs, so that they can breathe properly. Now if we talk about the aquatic animals, they are having gills. Their body is slippery, okay, and the scaly skin is there, so that they can swim in the water, they can survive, okay, which is waterproof also. And they are having the fins, which helps them to swim. And they are having the tails also, so that they can change the direction. So these are the adaptation that is taking place inside the body of an aquatic animals. Okay, so aquatic animals are having gills to breathe under the water. Okay, aquatic animals are having gills to breathe in the water. Now the amphibians, as I told you that the amphibians can live in water as well as they can live on land. So, do they have gills or they are having lungs? Dear student, the example of the amphibian is frog or the salamander. So the frog is having lungs. Okay, the frogs are having lungs which help the frogs to breathe when the frog is on the land. As they go in the water, so they the frog breathe from their moist skin. So when the frog is in the water, they breathe from their moist skin. When it is out or on the land, then it breathes from their lungs. So this is an adaptation, the thing that it is adapted, okay, according to their living habits. Now the next is the adaptation according to the eating habits. So first is the herbivores, okay. What are the herbivores? Herbivores are those animals which eat the plants or the plant parts. Okay, what are the herbivores? Herbivores are those animals which eat plants or the plant parts. Are known as herbivores animals. For example, like the cow, buffalo, goat, okay, horse. So these are the example of the herbivores. Now next is the carnivores animals. What are the carnivores animals? The animals which eat the flesh of the other animals. Okay, carnivores are those animals which eat the flesh of the other animals. Are known as carnivores animals. For example, like the leopard, the cheetah, lion, okay. So these are an example of the carnivore animals. Now what is the omnivores? Omnivores are those animals which eat the flesh as well as the plants, okay. So they are known as a omnivores animals. So for example, like the humans, okay, the human, we are also an omnivores. Why? Because we are eating the flesh also, okay, as well as we are eating the plant parts also. Okay, so these are the example of the omnivores. Now the parasite. What is parasite? Parasite are the small insects, okay, which live on or inside the body of any host. Okay, parasite are the insect or those animals which live on the body or inside the body of any host. So to survive to survive properly, they need a host, okay, on which they can live, they can survive, they can take their nutrition to grow. Okay, for example, like the mosquito. Mosquito, when it bites, it is sucking the blood from our body. So they need our blood so that they can survive. Okay, now the next is the hookworm. Okay, or the tapeworm. The tapeworm, it's need a host body, okay, body of the host, so that it can be survived. As they go inside the body, okay, then it grows. Okay, the size of the tapeworm, it increases. Okay, and it is dangerous also. The person can die even. It is dangerous as it goes to our brain. Okay, so it damages our brain also, so it is very harmful for us. So the tapeworm needs a host body. Okay, the same way other parasites are also there which live on the host body, and it is also dangerous for the body of the host. Okay, now the body structure of the animals which they have adapted according to the surroundings. So first is in color protection. So some of the animals, some of the insects, they are having some ability which they have adapted to hide themselves, okay, in the surrounding from their enemies. Okay, some of the animals are there which they have adapted some features, some characteristics which help them to hide themselves in the surrounding from their enemies. So that is known as a color protection. So you know that the leaf insect is there, which look exactly like a leaf. So as it sits on a leaf, the enemies cannot see, and the leaf insect can protect it from that enemy. Okay, so that enemy cannot eat that insect. The same way, another insect is there, that is a stick insect, which looks exactly like a wooden stick. Okay, so when that stick insect sits on a wooden stick or any branch of this tree, so the enemies which can eat them cannot see. Okay, so like this, the stick insects can protect itself from the other animals. Okay, now the next is in hibernation. What is hibernation? It is a time period in which the animal go in a long or prolonged sleep. Okay, hibernation is that time period in which the animal goes for a long sleep. Okay, that is in the season of winter. Okay, when it goes for a long sleep, when the animals hibernate, that is in winter season only. For example, like the polar bear, snake. Okay, so they go for a hibernation. Why they do so? Because in the winter season, the availability of the food is very less. So in the summer season, they eat so much, and their fur, their skin becomes so thick, which can make them easily survive in the winter season. Okay, so in the winter season, the polar bear or the snake, they go for the hibernation for prolonged sleep for at least 2 to 3 months. So that is known as hibernation. Okay, so dear students, this is all for today. I hope you like today's lecture. If you, please do like, share and subscribe my channel. In the next video, we will do the revision of the next chapter. So till then, keep learning, stay safe and stay